angry is God at sin? Look to the cross. How much does God value justice, righteousness, and truth? Look to the cross. Look to the battered and bruised body of the Son of God. See the blood stream from his wounds. Hear his cry of anguish. My God, why have you forsaken me? As the fury of a holy and just God came upon his body to make his soul an offering for sin. Some say that Jesus died for our sins, but that's not the total truth. If Jesus merely had to die when John the Baptist pointed him out as the Lamb of God, Jesus could have said, I am he, I am the Lamb, thrust me through with the sword, for I've come to die for the sins of the world. No, the Bible says, Christ must suffer. Christ must suffer. D.L. Moody said, to create, God only had to speak, but to redeem, he had to suffer. But more than that, the Bible said it pleased the Lord to bruise him. You see, we hardly get any understanding of what happened that day 2,000 years ago. So horrific was the sight of the Son of God writhing in agony for our sins. The Bible says he was more marred than any man, that God clothed the cross in blackness, that creation may not gaze upon the perfect Son of God. A.B. Earle was a famous evangelist of the last century who had 150,000 converts to substantiate his claims. Satan doesn't want you to get a grip of this, so listen very closely. A.B. Earle said, I have found by long experience, that's the true test, that the severest threatenings of the law of God have a prominent place in leading men to Christ. They must see themselves lost before they will cry for mercy. They'll not escape danger until they see it. Now the wonderful thing about God's law is that God has taken the time to write it upon our hearts. Romans 2 verse 15 would show the work of the law written in their hearts, the conscience bearing witness. Now conscience means with knowledge. Con is with, science is knowledge, conscience. So when he lies, lusts, fornicates, blasphemes, commits adultery, he does it with knowledge that it's wrong. God has given light to every man. The Holy Spirit convicts him of sin, righteousness and judgment. Sin which is transgression of the law, righteousness which is of the law, judgment which is by the law, conscience accuses him, work of the law written on his heart, and the law condemns him. So I say, if God judges you by this standard, on the day of judgment, you're going to be innocent or guilty. He says, guilty. I say, well, do you think you'll go to heaven or hell? And the usual answer is, heaven. But I say, why do you feel like that? Because you think God is good and he'll overlook your sin? He says, that's it. He'll overlook my sin. We'll try that in the court of law. You've committed rape, murder, drug pushing, very serious crime. The judge said, you're guilty. All the evidence is here. Have you anything to say before I pass sentence? And you say, yes, judge. I'd like to say, I believe you're a good man and you'll overlook my crime. The judge would probably say, you're right about one thing. I am a good man. And because of my goodness, I'm going to see that justice is done. Because of my goodness, I'm going to see that you're punished. And the very thing that sinners are hoping will save them on the day of judgment, the goodness of God, will be the very thing that will condemn them. Because if God is good, he must by nature punish murderers, rapists, thieves, liars, fornicators, blasphemers. God is going to punish sin wherever it's found. Charles Finney said, evermore the law must prepare the way for the gospel. He said, to overlook this and instructing soul is almost certain to result in false hope, the introduction of a false standard of Christian experience, fill the church with false converts. So with his knowledge, he's now able to understand in his life that his sin is primarily vertical, that he has sinned against heaven, that he has violated God's law, and he has angered God, and the wrath of God lies upon him. He can now see that he's weighed in the balance of eternal justice and found wanting. He can now understand the need for a sacrifice. Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law being made a curse for us. God commended his love toward us, and that while we yet sinners, Christ died for us. We broke the law, he paid the fine. It's as simple as that. And if a man will repent, if a woman will repent, put their faith in Jesus, God will remit their sins so that on the day of judgment, when their court case comes up, God can say, your case is dismissed through lack of evidence.
They must turn from sin and turn to. That's why I said in the book of Acts 26, he says, I was sent so that they might turn from darkness to right. And that's real conversion. Pastor Rice, if I get saved, do I got to give up my drugs? Are you and your drugs go sit back down?
We broke the law. He paid the fine. It's as simple as that.